king to give God glory and to give God praise. Is there anybody here today that can say, I may not be what I ought to be, but I thank God that I'm not what I used to be. I no longer curse people out every day. I no longer live a promiscuous life. I no longer need drugs. I no longer need alcohol. Is there anybody in here today that knows that it's because that God loved you, that God touched you, that God made a way for you, that even in your pitifulness, He answered your prayer?
Bless your name, God. Bless your name, God.
A funny thing happens when you give people a chance and not give up on them. God didn't give up on us, and we can't give up on ourselves or on anyone else. Anyone else, even if they appear to be dead in their sins. Ezekiel felt that he was speaking to the dead. Every now and then, do you feel as though you're just speaking to the dead? You're trying to talk sense to somebody who just ain't ready for you talking sense. But Ezekiel felt that he was speaking to the dead as he preached, because they rarely responded to his message. But the people did eventually respond. Just as God brought life to these dry bones, God can bring life to those who are spiritually more than bankrupt and dead today. If there is to be life after the grave, the first thing we must do, we must seek our answers from God. We know a whole lot is going on in our country before, but we've been this way before. God asked Ezekiel, son of man, can these bones live? Ezekiel responded, oh sovereign Lord, you alone know. The next time somebody asks you, can that little girl get herself together? You can say, only God knows. The next time somebody asks you, can something be made right which is wrong? You let them know that only God answers. Every now and then we try to answer for God. How can you answer for God when you can't get yourself out of your mess?
Preach! Preach!
Many of us are trying to deal with the challenges of life on our own. We seek advice from everybody and everything but God. But the Bible tells us to trust in the Lord with all our heart and lean not into our own understanding. That's part of our problem right there. We too busy leaning to our own understanding. Our own understanding says that we can't make brick without straw. Our own understanding says we'll never be able to cross the Red Seas of our lives. Our own understanding says that we'll never get across to the other side. But do I have anybody in here? You stop depending on yourself and you start depending on God. Do I have anybody in here that got a testimony that God brought you from the uttermost to the uttermost? Do I have anybody in here when God paid a bill that you didn't think could ever get paid? Do I have anybody in here when God put food on your table and you ain't had no money? Do I have anybody in here that just want to give God a praise break? Brothers and sisters, Jesus said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and righteousness.
Yes.
And all this other stuff is going to be added unto you. Job declared, though he may slay me, yet will I still trust him.
Yes.
I'm going to trust and never doubt.
Yes.
Because he surely will bring me out. I want to close this message, but I can't close right here, because there might be somebody in here right now that you trusted in God and you never doubted him. And did God make a way out of no way for you? bless his name. Bless the name of Jesus. So not only must you seek your answers from him, but secondly, if there is to be life after the grave, we must speak life to those things that are dead. We must call those things that are not as though they were. We have to speak life over our brothers and sisters who have been lost. We got to speak life over our children. Speak life over our family. Speak life over those hopes and those dreams that many folk have given up on. Anybody here know Howard Thurman, the great mystic, in his book, Jesus and the Disinherited, said that in the absence of all hope, our soul is corroded. It is wounded. Many of our brothers and sisters have given up because they have lost their hope. But when you speak life over them, when you let them know that God loves them, that we believe in them despite their troubles, they'll know that they can do all things through Christ that strengthens them. Many people must have thought that Dr. King was wasting time and was fooling himself, preaching to and trying to lead a people who was spiritually and emotionally dead by years of prejudice, by years of Jim Crowism, by years of racial segregation. Most people must have thought that these people have been dead too long. They become accustomed to their secondhand treatment. They become accustomed to stepping and fetching. They become accustomed for taking the crumbs. They become accustomed to being stepped on. But I'm so glad that when they heard the prophetic voice of God coming from the belly of Dr. King, people changed their song.